So hard to find time for this YouTube thing anymore. Starting to run out of ideas. I think it's been a good run. Maybe I should just stop now, you know? If you don't want me to stop, just give me a sign or something. Just like... Is that a jet windshield? Nice. Let's shoot it. Alright guys, so I got this jet windshield. Now, these windshields are bird-proof, but they're not necessarily bulletproof. And so, that's what I'm gonna be testing today. I got four of the main, more popular calibers. I got 22 long rifle, 9mm, 40 caliber, and 223 or 5.56. So we're gonna shoot all four of those, see what happens. If any of them do go through, I brought some water jugs to put behind it, just to see how much damage they can make while going through. But you know, we'll get to that point. I did not bring 45 ACP because everyone knows if I was using 45 ACP, it would just obliterate this windshield. It'd vaporize it pretty much, you know, to dust. Now, everyone knows that, so that's the only reason I didn't bring that. And my 300 Win Mag is currently stockless. If the 223 doesn't go through, I will bring my 300 Win Mag back out with this windshield and try that out. But for right now, let's stick with these popular calibers and see what happens. Place your bets down below which caliber you think will be the first one to go through. So let's kick it off with 22 long rifle. All right, so this made a pretty good impact. This is the 22 long rifle. It's gonna be hard to show you guys on the back, but I can actually feel some cracked glass right in the back. It's not necessarily like shards or, you know, pieces sticking out, but I could feel some cracks back there. So, I don't know what's gonna happen with 9mm. I'm pretty surprised that the 22 long rifle did this much damage. So let's keep going, see what happens. All right guys, up next we got 9mm. I actually brought some hollow points as well, so I'm gonna do one full metal jacket and then we'll do one hollow point. So let's see what happens. All right, now for the hollow point, I'm gonna go above the 22 long rifle. Alright, so this was our full metal jacket. Up here is a hollow point. As you guys can see, that side profile is really bulging out on that hollow point. This stuff almost like liquefies and starts to, I guess, splash out and then solidifies. I don't know what's happening really, but it's pretty crazy. I can see the bullet in this one, which tells me it did not go through. This is the full metal jacket. I actually feel absolutely nothing. No cracking or anything. Let me see, I gotta lift this up. Nope. Totally smooth. No cracking behind the full metal jacket. The hollow point. There's no penetration at all with the hollow point. Oh, it's like rubbery and soft. It's kind of cool. You see the entry right there. You can see a little bit of the red. Has one of those polymer tips to help the expansion. Cool. So no penetration still. All right, so now we're gonna move up to 40 caliber. I'm gonna do the same thing where my first round is gonna be a full metal jacket. My second round will be a hollow point. I'm gonna shoot off to the left and let's just see what happens. That's full metal jacket. Now for the hollow point. I'm gonna try to go a little bit above that. All right. Oh, all right. So the full metal jacket on this one definitely is kind of bubbling out a lot more than the hollow point. Neither one of them went through. They're completely smooth on the backside. No cracking, nothing. So that leaves us with 223 and 556. The 223 and 556 is a high-powered round. So it's small and light, but it's things moving. So generally things that are faster have more penetrating power. So I'm gonna guess that the 223 is gonna go right through it. But I don't know, this thing is giving me some weird results, so who knows? We'll have to find out. Let's see what happens. All right, guys, that was actually my bad for the last couple shots. I was not wearing my eyes. You guys need to make sure that every time you go shooting, especially when you're shooting something like glass or metal or anything that could have ricochets or debris come back at you, you gotta make sure you got some glasses on. Protect your eyes, okay? So this could be 223-556. Let's see what happens. I think that went through. This is the 223-556. I could actually already see pieces through the window behind it. It did, I don't know if you guys can see that. It did go through. So it's a high velocity round, pretty much what I figured was gonna happen. That's why I wasn't too worried about bringing my 300 Win Mag. If the 223 could go through, 300 Win Mag will definitely go through. Now that we know that goes through, I got some water jugs. I'm gonna put one behind that windshield and see what happens to the water jug. How much power is left after it goes through that windshield. So let's find out. All right, guys, I got two bottles of water down there. They're gallons behind the windshield. Place your bets down below if you think it's gonna get stopped in the first bottle, stopped in the second bottle, or if you think it's gonna go straight through both. Let's see what happens. Alright, so it looks like, from the looks of it, got stopped in the first bottle. There's the pieces of the bolt right there. Second bottle is totally fine. Alright, guys, well, it looks like a jet windshield is not totally bulletproof. It looks like it will stop the smaller cartridges like pistol rounds, handgun rounds, but you know, rifle rounds, high powered cartridges like that. There's way too much velocity. It does take a lot to stop a round like that. But, you know, cool nonetheless. And yeah, I think it was a fun experiment. All right, guys, well, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It'd be super cool if you guys subscribed to my channel. If you haven't done that already, be sure to share this video with all your buddies who you think would enjoy it. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Alright, guys, real quick, just going back to that intro, just trying to make a point. Whatever you guys are trying to do, whatever you want to do, it's gonna get tough. And when it gets hard, and when it gets to be almost impossible to do, at least that's what you think, don't give up. Don't ever stop. Just never quit. Don't you ever quit. I just hope you guys remember that. All right, bye. Been up since the crack of dawn, just trying to get paid. Been harder than 100 songs, I can't find no shade. Just two more rolls and I'm good to go. Yeah, I'm shutting this tractor down. Give me half an hour for a shave and a shower, then I'll be outside your house. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but I'm taking you uptown tonight. Might have a little mud on my wheels, but we're gonna shine with the up and sign. Gonna hit the club, go cut 'em up, burning up like neon lights. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but we're gonna dance the dust right off them tonight. Yeah.